I wanted to put low voltage lighting on my drill press, and I'm probably going to do the same thing on my scroll saw. This is a conversion for MR11, it's 12 volt, and this is white light. I don't like the blue cast on some of the LED bulbs or the warm white. This is bright white, so it's very similar to daylight. The pigtails that fit on the back of this bulb. And then the LED driver. This is 110 to 240, 50, 60 cycle line current, and that converts it to 12 volt DC. Small electrical parts like this you can find on eBay. Generally, they include free shipping from China or Hong Kong, and I have not had a problem with delivery of any of it. These items have taken 10 days to 3 weeks to show up, which is pretty good. The transformer is very clearly marked where the AC connects, and then it shows you where the DC connections are. And for these lights, you don't have to worry about plus and minus. Just hook them up on the DC side and they'll work. So I'm going to try two lights. The lighting in my shop is quite good, but if I don't have all the lights turned on, sometimes I'll get a shadow, and you can see the shadow being cast by the drill bit. Just for a test, I'm going to plug this in, hold this up here, and see how bright these lights are. These are going to be mounted up here on the head of the drill press. I think that'll be pretty good. These are LEDs. They do not get that hot. They, in fact, they're not even warming up. A regular MR11 bulb, low voltage lighting, gets very hot. You have to be careful where you put those. They could cause a fire. These are staying cool, so I'll be able to make a mounting bracket out of wood. And I'm going to use a magnet to attach that to the bottom of the drill press head. I'm going to drill a series of holes to make lamp holders. I'm going to go from largest diameter to smallest. This first one is just an indentation for this lamp to sit on. This recess pocket is 1 3/8 in diameter. Now I'm going to drill 1 1/4 inch diameter. It's going to go about 5/8 inch deep. I only want 4 of these. I'll always make a few extra in case I mess one up. The next hole is 3/4 inch in diameter, and it goes in 1 3/4 inches deep. That allows that light bulb to fit all the way in there. Now I'm drilling a small hole through the block to locate the center on the other side. Mounted the blank on the lathe, and the three-jaw chuck is grabbing the inside diameter. You have to be careful when you tighten this. You don't tighten it too much. It's real easy to split this wood. I have 3 different marks on here. I was keeping track of where the diameters change inside. All I need to keep track of now is this mark, which is 1 3/8 inch from this end. I have a 1 inch diameter marked on this end as a reference. I hogged that material off there pretty fast. I want this to be about 1 inch in diameter, and that's just a little bit under. That's good enough. The next step is to cut this taper. Now there's a lot of material to remove right in here. So what I'm going to do next is what I call stair-stepping. I'm just going to create a series of ledges or steps to get from this diameter to this diameter as evenly as I can. I'm just eyeballing that. Now that's pretty close to the angle that I want. I'll just clean that up with a file. After I sanded that, I just reverse it in the chuck, and now this is a little bit touchy because there's not much holding this, and I don't want to grip it so tight that it dents the wood. So you just have to be a little bit cautious with this and sand this and round over the edge. So the six pieces have been turned. They're not exactly the same, but they look pretty close. It's kind of fun to see how close you can get them when you're doing this freehand. And the light will fit in there like that. That's not the final configuration, but we're getting there. This is a 3/4 inch diameter wood ball. I want to put that inside this 3-jaw chuck. I do not want to drill into the end grain. I want to drill at right angles to the grain. I'm going to drill a 1/4 inch hole, 1/2 inch deep. Drilled a small hole in each of these locations, and that helps locate the larger bit, 5/8 Farschner bit. I drilled that from both sides so I didn't have any blowout. Then I used the 3/4 inch rotary file to put a little bit of a radius on here to match the curvature of the 3/4 inch wood ball. Now two of these will go together. There'll be a bolt that goes through here with a washer on either side, and you tighten that until you have just enough drag so that will stay in whatever position you put it in. The wires on this transformer or LED driver are a little bit short. If you don't want splices outside of this box, this is pretty easy to fix. Take this cover off. You can pry this piece off. Turn the circuit board over. And you can unsolder these four wires and replace them with whatever length wire you want. put it back together. Just that easy. I salvaged these magnets from a computer hard drive. There's one pair in each drive. And this one had legs that were sticking up at right angles. So I just cut those off with a hacksaw. I can use these holes to mount it to a piece of wood. I built my box, mounted my two salvaged magnets in here. And if this looks crooked, it is crooked. And I built it crooked on purpose. And I have a micro switch mounted in here. The head of the drill press is a steel casting, and this side is not parallel to the other side, and the bottom is not flat. It's tapered downward from both sides to the center. When I put this plate with the magnet on it, the only place it would engage both magnets was back here at the back, and then the piece of wood was no longer square with this side. I built this to appear to be square with this face, and I did the same with the other side. And as you can see, this side is built to be parallel with this face of the head. And my little micro switch is here. Line voltage power cord is coming in from this side. The LED driver or transformer will sit in here. This little micro switch has a normally open and normally closed position and will be wired to these two points, which is normally closed. This lid will screw to the top of the box. I've assembled all the pieces for the flexible joints for the lights. Wires will come through these two holes, which will connect with the transformer inside the box. And there'll be enough wire here to allow these to move into whatever position we need. And I've sprayed everything with two coats of Deft lacquer. Everything's wired. Just fold the wires in there, attach the lid, and we'll try it on the drill press. The lights are reattached with the magnet. I have the lights in the shop are on. Usually about half of the lights are on. They tend to cast a shadow in this direction. And these are intended to backfill. I turn that on. They're not blinding bright, but they fill in on the back side, and the shop lights are still shining over here. They're not in the way of the handle. A lot of times if you're using a large reflector light with a 60 or 100 watt bulb, that reflector invariably is in the way and it's hot. If you bang into it, you can get burnt. These are never going to burn you. They're sufficiently bright to light up the work area. If I want it a little bit brighter for some reason, I can pull them down, push them back up, get them out of the way. And when I'm done, turn it off. If for some reason these are in the way, I just pull it off of the magnets, do whatever I need to do, and then put it back in place. I just have a piece of wood that swings to engage and disengage with the micro switch. A toggle switch for your lights. Up is on, down is off. This is on, down is off. The clearance here is fairly close. It does not interfere with the drill press. Not like some of the large reflector lights that I've used in the past. That's with the light off. You can see the strong shadows from the shop light. When I turn it on, the point of the bit shows up very clearly. I'm working on another configuration of this for use on my bandsaw, and I'll post a separate video on that.